28-year-old female, seeking advice on hair loss treatment. What are my options? I'm a 28-year-old female. Since the beginning of last year, I noticed that hair on the top of my head started thinning. The gap became wider and wider. Now, under the sun, I can feel my scalp on the very top burns. I have been using Rogaine for 10 months now, but it doesn't seem to help much. I am currently considering PRP with ACell treatment, but I know that it is not effective at all for some people. What are my options? Thank you very much.
Thank you for your question. You're 28 years old, and you've submitted a photo of the top of the scalp showing your hair part. And you say that you started to lose hair about a year ago, and you've been on minoxidil for about 10 months or so, and you are looking into ACell and PRP, and you've learned that it doesn't always work for everybody, and so you want to learn more about your options. Well, I can certainly share with you how I approach patients like yourself in my practice who have similar concerns and issues. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Hair transplant and hair loss has been a very big part of my practice. In fact, I'm the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a system we developed that evolved from hair transplant surgery using acellular matrix and PRP, and we've been treating patients from all over the world, men and women, of a very wide range of ages. So I think I can help you just understand the landscape of what you're dealing with. So to begin with, it is certainly a little bit less common for a woman your age to have hair loss, and therefore it is actually very important to have a proper medical evaluation before you undergo any treatment. So what does that mean? Well, for a young woman, you want to make sure that hormonal levels are appropriate. So whether it's seeing an endocrinologist or your gynecologist, you want to check hormones such as testosterone, estrogen. You want to check vitamin D3. You want to check thyroid levels. There is essentially a hair loss workup panel, a combination of the hormone levels as well as complete blood count, making sure you're not anemic. And in fact, you can even look at certain inflammatory markers. So once you have a proper medical workup, in addition, we also look at family history. When we have treated younger women, we often see certain consistency with family history. Not every time, but for example, one of our youngest patients is 16 years old. She, when I was being told about her in the hall by my nurse before I went into the room, I was ready to do biopsies and other things to try to figure out what's going on. And then I learned because her mother had exactly the same condition with the same onset, it became clear that this was a familial trait. Nonetheless, it doesn't mean that you still don't get medical workup, but it means that at least you may fall into what is usually the 95% likelihood of something called androgenetic alopecia or genetic pattern hair loss. Now, doing hair regeneration treatment now for more than 7 years in our practice, we have, like I said, a wide range of patients of all ages, and in women, we're seeing large groups of women in their 20s and early to mid-30s who previously were not really being paid attention to because there really weren't many options. It's essentially the only FDA-approved drug is minoxidil, and most patients, most women who come to us will feel basically indifferent about the benefits of minoxidil. So as far as the question of acellular matrix and PRP, it is something that I am very happy to see that more people are validating the benefits of these treatments. The challenge is the what we had to overcome over many years, being in the front of the parade and being the first of a handful of doctors to be pursuing this more than 7 years ago. Essentially, what the challenge is the formulation, the method of placement, and the strategy for the individual patient. And what we developed was an algorithm for patients based on gender, age of onset, degree of hair loss, and rate of progression. And from that, I developed formulations and systems based on my clinical experience. So when the question is about whether or not ACell+PRP always works, well, I can tell you as of recently, for the past several years, treating women, we've almost basically haven't had any treatment failures for women with androgenetic alopecia, which means genetic pattern loss. Now, as I often tell my patients, is your scalp didn't read a textbook, so you don't always get to have just one diagnosis. You can have androgenetic alopecia with telogen effluvium, you can have it with alopecia areata, you can have it with lichen planopilaris, you can have a lot of things happening concurrently. So there are times when I would take a patient like yourself and I would even do biopsies in three separate areas just to confirm diagnosis. And when our strategies is to develop treatment plans based on those particular characteristics I just mentioned and do treatments based on that strategy. So we're actually managing hair loss. We're not just doing injections and just hoping for the best. We actually have strategies based on our clinical experience. So I think it's reasonable for you to still pursue this injection type of treatment, but be confident about who is doing it for you so you feel like they have the experience needed to do the best job they can for you. Understanding hair loss is a progressive condition and there is nothing that will work forever. But essentially, if you can reactivate hair growth and improve coverage, then you are better off at any given point of time after the injection. Let's say in our practice, we tell our patients, expect improvement generally for women at around 9 months. And we follow our patients every 3 to 6 months. And a lot of times we find it, we see growth earlier. But in terms of getting density and coverage, it takes about 9 months for most women. So I think it's important to learn more, do some more research, get your medical workup done, and decide if you want to go ahead and try something other than minoxidil. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.